Hello. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Fiona Dwi Febriani with study number G1E02003. And today, I would like to present you about a material from morphology class. The material is about a definition of morpheme and bound morphemes and free morphemes. And here we go. The first one is the definition of morpheme. What is morpheme? A morpheme is a short segment of language that meets three basic criteria. First, it is a word or a part of a word that has meaning. Second, it cannot be divided into smaller meaningful segments without changing its meaning or leaving a meaningless remainder. Third, it has relatively the same stable meaning in different verbal environments. There are two types of morphemes, free morphemes and bound morphemes. And check this out. Free morphemes. A morpheme that has individual meaning and can be formed independently is called a free morpheme. For examples such as free, get, song, love, happy, set, may, march, but, and, when, etc. All of the individual words that have individual meanings and all of them are free morphemes. Free morphemes can be categorized into two subtypes. They are A. Lexical morphemes. The lexical morphemes are those morphemes that are large in number and independently meaningful. The lexical morphemes include nouns, adjectives, and verbs. These types of morpheme are called lexical morphemes. For example, dog, good, honest, boy, woman, excellent, etc. B. Grammatical and functional morphemes. The grammatical or functional morphemes are those morphemes that consist of functional words in a language such as prepositions, conjunctions, determiners, and pronouns. For example is an, but, or, above, on, into, after, the, etc. For the last is bound morphemes. A morpheme that doesn't have any independent meaning and can be formed with the help of free morphemes is called a bound morpheme. For example, such as less, ness, pre, on, and, sif, meant, etc. Bound morphemes can be categorized into two subclasses. They are A. Bound roots. Bound roots are those bound morphemes that have lexical meaning when they are included in other bound morphemes to form the content words. For example is sieve, tain, perceive, deceive, retain, contain, etc. B. Affixes. Affixes are those bound morphemes that naturally attach different type of words and used to change the meaning or function of those words. For example such as meant in payment, enjoyment, entertainment, and in enlighten, in hedge, enlarge, as in Joseph's, Laura's, in reading, sleeping, singing, etc. And that's all for my explanation about morphemes. Thank you for watching. Bye.